Hello, I have received a big box from Psytronic Software, and this means we will have a short unboxing session and short gameplay. And I emphasize the word short because I want to keep my videos, or at least I'm working on getting my videos a little bit more structured and not as extensive as the former videos perhaps. And so I will post in the comment or in the video description, I will post the time when I am changing the topic in the video, so that for you guys who are a little bit short on time, which I perfectly understand, there are so many things on the internet and in real life to watch, that maybe not all of you can spend that much time going through the whole video. You will have some kind of milestones, and then you can skip forward to the section which is more interesting to you or whatever. So anyway, stop chatting. Let's have some progress. And let's have a look what's going to be inside. And just as a, well, kind of a teaser or so, these are not really new games. These are just games which were released in a, let's say, certain form, and therefore I'm really looking forward what's going to be inside the box. And here we got the first one. Oh no, it's already the whole package, and as usual, a roll and some packaging material. And let's get rid of it quickly. And as you may already spotted, that's going to be Steel Ranger. And hopefully another one. Just another adhesive battle. Oh, pretty sticky this time. And I think there's going to be another one, as usual. There we go. And as you can see, it's Pains and Aches, and it's a pretty nice adventure. I just played it very, very briefly as a digital download. So, and that's going to be the more interesting part to me, at least. As you may have seen, I already started to play Steel Ranger, and it was the digital download version. And unfortunately, I got stuck somewhere in some of the first levels. And well, let's use a knife for this one. It's really, they changed this adhesive tape. Former times I was able to remove it, but this time it's really... And well, yeah, I got stuck somewhere in the first levels, and but I have it on my agenda to return to the game. And that's pretty nice. That's the map of the game, at least a part of it. And I'm actually somewhere, I think here in this area, and got kind of lost. And I think if we're going to turn this over, we have the other part of the map. And oh no, I'm here in the green part. Yeah, the other part of the game. And that's really nice. And you have some kind of in-game map, but let's have this while playing the game. And here's a Steel Ranger poster. Well, it's pretty shiny, so I hope you can see that this is really, really looking nice. And well, I'm blown away. It's fantastic. It looks very nice. So well, now I have to find a spot to place the poster to it. And the map is delivered as a download version as well, and that's pretty handy. It's a very huge bitmap, it's a pixel map, and therefore you can check where you are in the game. And let's put this aside. And let's move on to the first thing, Steel Ranger. And this is the deluxe edition, I think. And therefore, so the box is the same like the cover. So it looks very amazing. I'm impressed. And the box has a nice format. It's not this longer version. It's more like a compact version. And here we have some protective material. Let's put this aside. We got a Steel Ranger sticker that looks pretty amazing. Not as colorful as the box, but basically the same style. And then we got even more Steel Ranger sticker. Very nice. That's cool. Very C64-ish. And we got a user manual. So that's actually not really extensive, but I think the game itself is not very, it's not so complex that it requires 20 pages of a manual or something like this. And here we see this in-game map where you can check in reference to the huge map where you are right now. And some status display interaction. Continue, save, end. So, very nice. Very interesting. Then we have a Steel Ranger postcard. And that's basically the intro screen from the game. Looks very nice as well. And, oh, we can turn it over. So it's probably not a postcard. No, I'm wrong. It's just a card you can place somewhere on your desk. Very nice. And then we have a disk, so call it floppy disk. With custom sticker on it, and it's perfectly aligned as well, and that represents the same scheme. And taking care of your Psytronic software disk. So they really printed a special cover for the disk. Very nice. Then we have a huge Commodore 64 sticker. That's very nice. So, well, I'm impressed. That's really a good idea. It's metal. It's really a solid quality. Looks very nice. And, well, I think I have an idea when I'm going to wear this. Then we have, well, as expected, a Steel Ranger sticker. Same style, like the disc, the manual, the box, the card, everything. That's very cool. And then we have a keychain with two different pictures. Oh. Get it out of this one. So we have the Steel Ranger, as seen a couple of times right now, and we have this in-game intro screen, so C64 graphics. Very nice. That's almost too nice to have it on a key or something like this. And then we have a C64 soundtrack CD. So that's basically a music disc, I think so. And here we have a couple of titles. So actually, let's see, 26 titles. So just checking whether they changed the numbers in between or so. And that's very nice. I have actually no chance to play this except for my laptop, perhaps. There's a CD drive. But anyway, let's have a look inside. Because it comes with a nice addition to this. Kind of a paper thingy that well kind of protects your CD. And here we have some in-game screens, and just have to avoid the reflection. It's a little bit tricky. Some in-game screens, and the mighty Steel Ranger here as well. And the Steel Ranger keeps chasing us, so it's all over. And here we have a compact disc, digital audio music disc. Let's try to get this out of it. And well, very interesting. That's really something I have to test. And but probably not today. Really have to figure out how to play music CDs. That's not very common nowadays. So let's try to put this back into our box. I think it's I'm not going to get this back into this kind of plastic thingy. Oh, will it work? Usually it sticks to the front of the CD and then you're lost. And well, anyway, let's keep it like this. So then let's put it back into the box. So very nice. So for this one we would require a normal 1541 or 1571, whatever, 5 1/4 disk drive, where I have actually no space for placing it. So and here we have a very nice card. Let's put it back again. And the manual and all those nice stickers. Very nice. And this additional gadget stuff here. Put it on the bottom of the box. And this very nice Commodore 64 button. That's really something I have to put on my shirt. So, that's about the box of Steel Ranger. Now let's move on to Pains and Aches Premium Plus Edition. So, there's a very nice darkish cover. Looks pretty promising. And as usual, it is wrapped in plastic. So let's see how we can get into this one. And see what's Premium Plus, what's going to be inside. So that's a different format. So that's a huge hard plastic box. I'm having a hard time opening it. And as you can see, everything is stuffed into this part here. So let's get it out and put this aside and see what's going to be inside this one. So here we got some instructions, short story, and in-game controls. Joystick and port 2, can skip the intro, move left, right, jump, drop down, space, view, map. So there's a map, okay. And, well, some inventory controls. So we have some kind of inventory, interacting with characters, boss battles, okay, boss battles, coins, and credits. So, and here we got this same style disc with a custom disc cover and a very nice and shiny sticker on top, with loading instructions. And what I really like, I haven't recognized this on Steel Ranger, perhaps it's going to be the same, that the cover and the disc image, it's the same picture. So that's pretty cool. That's amazing. I really like that they did this. And yeah, well, And for this one, we would need a floppy drive as well. So I think we go for the digital version as well. But in order to do so, I have to prepare a couple of things on my desk. So basically, for this unboxing video, that's going to be all for today. And we will have separate videos for the game itself. And I hope it was kind of interesting to you as well. So it's really nice to have the hardware version of the games as well. So the digital download is quite comfortable. You get it immediately when you order the games, and then you can start playing. But having some real physical stuff in your hands, and especially for your shelf maybe later on, that's a very nice thing. And let's have a last quick look at the Steel Ranger. And now it's a little bit different. Okay, so, but anyway, very nice. And yeah, for the next video I will go to test the Steel Ranger version. I mean, I already did some kind of review, so you find this in my playlist as well. But we will have a look at the audio disc as well, to listen to the soundtrack. And I will have kind of a gameplay of Pains and Aches. And then let's have some game review as well. I haven't played this very shortly, what I mentioned before, but I never dived into it very deeply. So perhaps I will say a couple of words about this game as well. So, well, as usual, thank you very much for watching. And if you have any questions or comments, if you want to know something about this, and feel free to use the comment section. And if you want to stay informed about the next videos, then feel free to subscribe. I highly appreciate it. And then, as usual, bye-bye.